Hey guys, Forex here, hope you're all well. What you're looking at in front of you is a fully working Sony PlayStation. As you can see, it's playing a bit of Tomb Raider 2. Now what I'm going to do today, you may have already noticed, is I'm going to install this X station. So if you stick around, I'll crack on with that. Now before I start stripping it down, I thought I'd tell you what model I'm putting the X station in. This is a 5552 model. It's a PAL version and it has the PU18 motherboard. So yeah, let's start getting in this thing. It's very easy to do. If I flip over the PlayStation, there's 6 screws I need to remove. There's one here, 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 and the final one is here. Remove those, I can turn it over and the top lid will pull straight off. Now that's the top lid removed. What I want to do now is remove the optical block. It's very easy to do. The ribbon cable is just push fitted. So what I'm going to do is just grab it and I'm going to pull the optical ribbon out, and then I'm going to pull the sled motor and spindle motor power out. And that's it. That's the optical block removed. Now obviously I need to get to the motherboard to work on this, but first I need to get rid of the metal shield. But first I need to remove a couple of cables. The first one is the memory port and controller port cable. Just simple, pull it out from this connector here. It's just push fitted, you can pull it out. Second one is the power board to the motherboard. Very simple, pull that out. Now all I need to do is remove 3 screws. There's one here, there's one here, and the final one is here. If I remove those, I can take off the metal shield. That's the metal shield removed. What I need to do now is remove 5 screws and then I can get the motherboard out. And the first screw is here, there's another one here, there's one here, there's one here, and the final one is here. Remove those and I'll be able to pull the motherboard out from its case. And that's the motherboard out, ready to work on. Now the first thing I need to do, if I flip it over and show you, is remove the old mod chip, which is a shame really, because whoever did this did a really nice job. That's the old mod chip removed. Now if you're wondering what it was an MM3 mod chip, multi-mode 3, you can tell, because it only had 7 wires. But yeah, I'm all ready to go, ready to install the X station. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get all set up and then I'll show you my setup of how I'm going to do this. And I'm all set up, ready to first lift some pins on a chip that I have to do. As you can see, I've got my microscope all set up. I've got the PlayStation board under it, ready to go. But first I wanted to show you the tools I'm going to be using. The first one is a pin that I've had for years. It's got a little hook on the end and it's great for hooking pins on chips, especially this small. I use this for doing SNES PPUs and CPUs and doing the switchless mods. I've made this God knows how many years ago and it's never let me down. And I've also got a scalpel and I need that later on. So I'm going to use the pick. If I have a little bit of problem with that, I'll probably move over to the scalpel. So yeah, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get cracking on installing the X station.
this to.
and that's the chip taken care of. All the legs have been lifted. Now you may have noticed that I actually lifted one of the wrong legs. Shit happens, guys. What are you going to do? But I managed to salvage it, and it just shows you how far you can bend these legs. I bent that thing right over and I managed to get it back. But that was all me being a moron. Thought I got the memory map of the legs I needed to lift in my head, and I got one of them wrong. So yeah, follow the guide properly, guys. But yeah, I salvaged it. And what I need to do now is start installing the QSB quick solder board. So yeah, I'll crack on with that bit. That's the QSB, quick solder board, all taken care of, soldered in. What I need to do now is take care of the crystal. And that's everything installed. What I can do now is get this all back together and we can give it a test. Now before I get the X station in the PlayStation, there's another thing I need to do. I need to remove this post here. So I'm going to take my side cutters and just cut that post off. And then when I've done that, I can put it all back together and we can give it a test. Fingers crossed, it works. As you can see, that's that post removed. So let me get this X station in this now, and we can give it a test. And as you can see, we're all back together. X station's installed. Not too difficult, guys. Once you've got the QSB installed, you've just got to do some cable management with this ribbon, and that's it, you're in. So let's power this thing on. Now I'm not going to lie to you guys, I've already booted this once. And you'll see my camera focuses that it does actually boot. And there we go. Now a top tip for you guys, if you turn it on and it doesn't boot, don't forget about the lid catch button. This has got to be pressed in for this to boot. And as you can see, we're all booted up. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get the lid back on this and I can give it a better test. And as you can see, we're all installed. Shut the lid, power on. Now I've already gone ahead and updated the firmware on this thing. It's not too difficult, guys, you just copy it to a SD card, go to update firmware, and it pretty much does it. about 30 seconds, and as you can see, there it's booting. And here's the X Station menu. So I've got Resident Evil on there, just to Resident Evil 3 Nemesis, just to test it. So let's start Resident Evil 3. And there we go. And you can see it's switched into NTSC because it's clashing with my camera. But yeah, there you go guys, X Station install. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. Like, comment, subscribe, all the usual stuff. And as always, I'll catch you on the next one. Yay. No more skippy discs. Catch you next time, guys.